I am expecting that you made a good understanding now about the sequential and concurrent statements and their execution style. If yes, then there is a tweak for you, but it is important because this will help you in deeper understanding of their uses effectively. But before this, if you are not familiar with these two types of statements and their differences, I will recommend you to go through my last session on this topic and then jump back here, because this is important to understand the difference between how sequential statements operate and how concurrent statements operate. Okay, let's start. Here, I written two architectures with identical statements. Top left architecture will execute those statements concurrently, but bottom right architecture will execute statements sequentially. Here, if you notice that in both the statements, the output signal is same, that is D out. And we are saying D out gets the value of logical AND of inputs. And in the second statement, we says D out gets the value of logical OR of inputs. Now, take a pause here and think about the semantic results first, which you can expect from the synthesizer tool. Let's try to design it how it is described. So let's talk about the concurrent statements first. You will say, okay, there is an AND gate and there is an OR gate, and the output of both the gates are interconnected with each other and gives the output D out. Can you figure out any problem in this structure? If your answer is no, then try to figure out the output if input A is 0 and input B is 1. So the output of the AND gate is digital 0 and the output of the OR gate is digital 1, and you shorted them both these outputs. This is not good for the hardware, right? This is called contention because two sets of logics are driving the same signal and this is not allowed to synthesize as well. So, you will not be able to synthesize your design and you will probably get the synthesizer error in such cases. Now, let's talk about the sequential statements. Here, we have the same set of statements, but these are now executing sequentially. Means, first statement executes first, which says output D out gets the value of logical AND of inputs. So, we made an AND gate. Now execute the second statement, which says output D out gets the value of logical OR of inputs. So here the second statement overrides the output signal D out, which means at the end of this statement D out has the value of OR function, and the first statement of the AND function gets ignored completely, and we will get the only functionality of the OR gate. Now, let's try to understand why we need the sequential statement. We will understand this with the example of this XOR gate. What is XOR gate? So, XOR gate will give you the output 0 when both the input A and input B are same. And if these inputs are not same, you will get 1 as the output. You can look over the truth table quickly. Okay, we are designing this XOR gate with two different styles. First, in the bottom left is the architecture with logical design, which is very simple, that D out gets the value of A XOR B. And second, in the bottom right is the architecture with the behavior design, where we describe the behavior of our system. It is sequential and inside the process with the if condition. So the function is, if input A equals to input B, then D out gets the value 0, else D out gets the value 1, and if and process. Now consider if the statements inside the process executes concurrently, then what will happen? If your answer is that it's contention, then you are right, because when the statement D out gets a value of 0 will execute, at the same time D out gets a value of 1 will execute. and this is contention because one wire cannot be 1 and 0 at the same timestamp. So here is the concept of sequential statements comes. And there is no wonder that in your designs you will going to use that if else statements very widely. And these must be written inside the process because these can only execute with sequential execution. So now if you simulate both of your architectures, both will give you the same results. And when you synthesize them, you will get the XOR gate as a symmetric output. So both the architectures are good and giving the same results in the simulation and synthesis. Till now, we have taken the handsome examples to understand sequential and concurrent statements. I feel that you would have the good understanding of the uses of both styles of statements. So what style will you prefer for your designs? Well, the simple answer is the mixed style, mean you will use concurrent statements and sequential statements both in your designs. You can design any part of your digital system in both styles, so you have the flexibility to choose yourself which style you wanted to use where. And very soon when you go through these practical sessions, you will definitely figure out that. Now let's take an example of mixed style having the concurrent statements and sequential statements. Before we start writing the architecture, just have a look to the schematic first. It is similar example we used in our last session. We segregated the structure in two sections and we will be writing the concurrent statements for the area 1 and we will define the behavior for the area 2 inside the process for sequential execution. Now look at our architecture. It is architecture behavior of my design is, then define two internal signals S1 and S2 as shown is schematic. So write signal S1 colon bit semicolon, signal S2 colon bit semicolon. Begin. Now write the concurrent statements for the area 1. These are signal S1 gets the value of A NAND B semicolon. Then type signal S2 gets the value of NOT C semicolon. Now type the process for sequential statements. Type process, then in the bracket type S1 comma B comma S2 bracket close, which are our inputs for this process. Type begin and write the conditional statement. Write if S1 equals to 1 and B equals to 1 and S2 equals to 1, then output Y gets the value of 1, else Y gets the value of 0. And if and process and architecture. Now, can you tell me how many concurrent statements written in this architecture? Some of you might say there are two concurrent statements, but that is not true. Here we have three concurrent statements. Two, you guessed right, that signal S1 and signal S2 gets their function in concurrent execution. But remember the process statement as well. Anything we write inside the process will execute sequentially. But process itself is a concurrent statement and it will execute at the same time when two other concurrent statements are executing. So we have total three concurrent statements in this architecture. Also note that the whole process body starting from the process to the AND process will be considered as a one single concurrent statement. This may take little time to absorb these things, but you do not need to worry because these things gonna be used very frequently in our designs and you will be familiar with them very soon. Also, I will be covering these topics in more details in upcoming sessions, so stay tuned for the updates. Until then, subscribe us and press the notification icon. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and leave a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe for regular updates.